I'm Ben Moran.
And I'm Christina Garrido.
And you're watching BCC TV.
Hey Ben, what's going on in the news this week?
The CEO of Google, Sundar Pichai, is now the head of Google's parent company, Alphabet, as co-founders Larry Page and Sergey Brin stepped down from the position.
On Monday, the U.S. Trade Representative concluded that France's digital service tax is discriminatory to U.S. companies like Google, Amazon, and Facebook. Following the conclusion, the U.S. proposed tariffs on up to $2.4 billion of French goods.
In more tariff news, President Trump tweeted on Monday that he would impose tariffs on steel and aluminum imports from Brazil and Argentina, citing a massive devaluation of their currencies that is not good for our farmers.
On Tuesday, the 2nd, U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals in New York ruled that Deutsche Bank and Capital One must comply with a request from Congress extensive information about President Trump's finances. This ruling found that lower court had acted properly in upholding congressional subpoenas for Trump's financial records.
In local news, a man was arrested on Monday for vandalizing the historic D.C. synagogue 6th and I with anti-Semitic graffiti. The graffiti consisted of multiple swastikas being drawn in red pen and the word Jew carved into a door. Heather Moran, 6th and I's CEO and executive director, said in a statement to Newsweek that while the damage to the building is minimal and will be fixed quickly, the emotional scars of such a hateful act will take longer to heal. This incident follows a pattern of increased anti-Semitic vandalism in the U.S. and in our local community, with swastikas being drawn in our own school bathroom recently, and just last Friday, a swastika being drawn on a desk at Silver Creek Middle School.
In BCC News, last Monday, BCC competed in the 20th annual MCPS Latin Dance Junior Division competition for the first time. Students danced merengue, bachata, salsa, and the cha-cha, among others. The event was also opened by BCC's spoken word artist Camilo Montoya. Congrats to the student dancers and Ms. Lloyd, BCC TV stand and dance teacher extraordinaire, for all her work supporting the dancers.
This just in. Everyone and their grandmother from BCC is famous on TikTok now. Looks like a lot of people are going to have to find a new hobby to make them seem unique.
A data breach that took place in October, in which a student hacker was originally thought to have acquired the personal information of 1,300 students from Wheaton High School, turns out to have actually accessed the information of over 6,000 students from six different schools. The information stolen included SAT scores, GPAs, students' IDs, and phone numbers. No charges have been filed against the student hacker yet.
Yo, is BCC one of the schools on the list?
Nah.
Hey Barons, we've had a great week of sports as fall season comes to an end. First, cross country ran at their state championship meet on Saturday. Boys finished 14th and girls finished 16th. Our runners had a great season. Congratulations to the It's Academic team for getting their first win last Saturday at the NBC4 Studios. The team blew Washington International and Fairfax out of the water with a score of 775. They're going to playoffs in February. Keep bringing in those dubs, guys. Good luck to everyone who's trying out for winter sports this week. Well, that's all for the sports this week. Now, to Isaiah and Sydney with some info about Baron Brigade.
Thanks, Aiden. What's up, Barons? I'm Sydney.
And I'm Isaiah. Baron Brigade is booming this season. For those who don't know, Baron Brigade is a point system that pits the grades against each other at school events that have historically low attendance.
Wait, but how do you record that you've attended a Baron Brigade event?
Well, Sydney, there's a QR code to scan, which can be found at the ticket booth and in the crowd at the games and events. You scan the code, fill out the form, and you'll receive a point for your class.
Our point system is simple. If you attend a Baron Brigade event, you get 1 point for your grade. The grade with the most points by December 11th will win the grand prize, a party for those that attended three or more Baron Brigade events.
Hey Sydney, what are the scores looking like?
Currently, class of 2022 is in the head with 93 points. Following up, we have class of 21 with 73 points, 2020 with 71 points, and in fourth place, 2023 with 14 points.
Dang, those freshmen gotta get their spirit up. Are there any events left?
Yeah, we have two more events left in the season. The fall musical, The Little Mermaid, on November 22nd, and Happy Day today. Get your points up. We'll announce more on our Instagram at BaronBrigade2020.
We also have a fundraiser at Chipotle on November 19th from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m., so make sure to come out to that.
That's all we got this time. We'll be back soon with more updates.
Roll Rons, baby. Back to you, Ben and Amelia.
Thanks, guys.
Yo, Amelia. What's going on in the news this week?
The Indian government has passed a controversial citizenship law that discriminates against Muslims and in some cases strips them of their basic rights. The law is part of Prime Minister Modi's nationalist politics in the world's second largest country. Protests against the law have compared it to Nazi policies in the 1930s.
Congress and the White House have agreed on a new budget deal consisting of $1.4 trillion in spending and averts a government shutdown. This compromise package includes funding for President Trump's border wall, repeals some of the Affordable Care Act's taxes, raises the age of tobacco purchases to 21, funds gun violence research, and appropriates additional funding for the census in 2020.
In local news, new video surfaces of a Bethesda jewelry store being robbed by three suspects last Friday evening. One of the suspects showed the employee his handgun and demanded them to hand over the jewelry, stealing $60,000 worth of merchandise.
A 17-year-old Walter Johnson student was struck by a Jeep while crossing the street to get on his bus last Friday morning. Police spokesman Tom Jordan stated the bus's arm was out and its flashing lights were on, indicating the bus was stopped and loading students. The student is in the hospital with life-threatening injuries.
All I Want for Christmas Is You has reached the number one spot on the charts for the first time in 20 years.
Yo, that song is a certified slapper. What's your favorite?
Let's pass it to Aiden for the sports report.
Hey Barons, we've had an exciting week of sports as wrestling starts us off with a win against Springbrook, the defending state champs, 41-22 on Saturday. They absolutely dominated against Gaithersburg on Tuesday and are now headed to West Virginia this weekend, getting a total of 8 matches, including the 1A defending state champ. Good luck to all our wrestlers. Girls basketball beat Northwood last Thursday, then went on to play Watkins Mill on Wednesday, winning 73-29. The girls move on to a 3-0 record. Keep up the great work. They play against Gaithersburg tonight at Gaithersburg. Boys basketball also won against Northwood last Thursday, then unfortunately took a loss in overtime to Watkins Mill on Wednesday. They have a game tonight at home against Gaithersburg at 7:15, so make sure to come out and show your support. Swim and dive had a meet against Sherwood last Saturday, with both girls and boys winning. The team had an abundance of PRs, season bests, and great finishes. Congrats to our bocce team for a great win against Churchill on Tuesday. Good luck in the upcoming games after break. Indoor track and field unfortunately did not run in their meet on Monday due to the snow day, but they do have a meet tomorrow from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. at PG Sportsplex. Wish your runners good luck and come out to support. That's all for the sports this week. Back to you, Ben and Amelia.
Thanks, Aiden.
And that's all for 2019, Barons.
Check back in next year for more news, updates, and humor. Keep the standards high.
And stay classy, BCC.
I'm Amelia Stanley.
And I'm Ben Moran.
And we're signing off.